dear students, and in today's session we are going to start with another unit number 7, respiratory system, respiratory disorders and diseases. So this is that particular unit, nursing management of child with respiratory diseases and disorders. And in the unit itself, it is divided into upper respiratory and lower respiratory tract diseases. So today we will be discussing about one of the upper respiratory tract disease, and it is very unfamiliar for you, and it's very new for you, I think, and it is croup. So CROUP, croup. I don't think you will be knowing better regarding this particular disease, and it is a very common disease of childhood. It is uncommon in adults. So what is croup and what are the conditions in this? What are the symptoms and signs and how we can manage? Today we will be discussing about these all things in croup. So croup, it is a general term applied to a system complex characterized by hoarseness, a resonant cough, varying degrees of inspiratory stridor and varying degrees of respiratory distress resulting from swelling or obstruction in the larynx or in the region of larynx. So listen properly. Croup is not a disease. Okay, it is a general term if the person is presenting with 4 typical manifestations. So they are the hoarseness. The person will have a hoarseness. The second is resonant cough, barking cough. Like barking cough will be present in that particular person. Inspiratory stridor. So during inspiration, you can hear the voice and it will be difficult. And there will be respiratory distress. So these 4 symptoms usually seen when a person is having swelling or obstruction in the upper airway or upper respiratory tract. Usually it can be seen in the larynx or in nearby areas of larynx. So this is the croup. Hope you understood. It is a general term if these all symptoms are present. And one more addition, these symptoms will be present when there is a swelling or obstruction in the upper regions or upper respiratory tract. So this is a croup. So we can see why it is happening and what are the details. So hope you understood croup, what it is. So we can see the croup, like in the upper respiratory, it may be epiglottitis or in the part of larynx or in the upper airway, any inflammation or any airway swelling is happening, and that leads to croup. Then regarding the incidence, croup is a common respiratory disease of childhood and occurs more in boys than in girls. We cannot explain why in boys maybe they will be getting more exposure from the environment. That may be the reason. But it is very common among childhood. Okay. And one more thing. These 4 symptoms, as we already discussed, there are 4 symptoms. What are they? They are the hoarseness, resonant cough, varying degrees of inspiratory stridor and varying degrees of respiratory distress. These 4 symptoms can be seen in 4 disease conditions. So croup syndrome, it is a syndrome complex, symptom complex with 4 disease conditions. So these 4 manifestations can be observed in these 4 conditions, and these all together are known as croup syndrome. So the first one is acute laryngotracheobronchitis. The second is acute epiglottitis. The third one is acute spasmodic laryngitis, and the fourth one is bacterial tracheitis. So in these 4 conditions, these 4 symptoms will be there, and it is upper respiratory tract infections, and these are the parts of Croup syndrome. Hope you clear. So Croup syndrome means there are four disease conditions with four manifestations as a common, and they are acute laryngeal tracheobronchitis, acute epiglottitis, acute spasmodic laryngitis, bacterial tracheitis. So in Croup we have to discuss about each one of these conditions in detail. So we can see the first conditions, that is acute laryngeal tracheobronchitis. So in this word itself, it's very clear, it is an inflammation. Itis means inflammation, and what all areas are inflamed is larynx, trachea and some part of bronchi. So these all upper airways are involved and it leads to laryngeal tracheobronchitis, which gives the common manifestations of Croup, and it is a part of Croup syndrome. Acute laryngeal tracheobronchitis, it is the most common type of Croup experienced by children admitted for hospitalization, and this is the inflammation of the larynx, trachea, bronchi in varying degrees. So these are the parts of inflammation, larynx, trachea, bronchi in varying degrees. Regarding the incidence, it occurs more common or often in boys than in girls. Like any Croup is commonly seen in boys. Second is case increases in the late of autumn and through early winter months. So seasonal variations are there. And third point is occurs primarily in children 6 months to 3 years. So very small children are affected more commonly than the elder ones. Regarding the etiology, it is primarily a viral infection, that is Parira para influenza virus type 1, that is the most common reason. Then para influenza virus type 3, para influenza virus type 2, RSV, influenza respiratory syncytial virus, influenza A and B, Mycobacterium pneumoniae. So mainly it is caused by virus, and that is para influenza virus type 1. So this is according to the cases it is listed. So the type 1 is most common, and next is type 3, and next is type 2. Then RSV and influenza A, B and B and Mycobacterium pneumoniae. So these are the etiological factors for acute laryngeal tracheobronchitis. Next we can see the pathophysiology of acute laryngeal tracheobronchitis. So when there is inflammation of mucosa of larynx and trachea, so that is laryngeal tracheobronchitis. So upper airways are undergoing some inflammatory changes as a result of the inflammation or infection with this virus. Inflammatory changes in the upper airway is happening, especially in the larynx and trachea. So in that particular upper airway area, what happens is narrowing of the airway. So larynx and trachea, it is inflamed, become edematous, and there will be narrowing of the airway. So air is not able to enter properly into the lower airway because of this obstruction in the upper airway. So there will be struggle to pass air through the obstruction to the lungs. So we know oru tube inde ullil oru block undayi kayumbol adu kuda air pass cheyan vendi this will be struggling. So air intake is okay, but it is not crossing the upper airway like larynx, trachea and some part of the bronchi, and it is not able to enter into the lung field to get the aeration. So that is the reason struggling will happen to pass air through the obstruction to the lungs. So child is struggling to make the entry of air into the lungs. There will be inspiratory stridor and retraction. So during that time the child is taking more struggle to get in the air, but it leads to inspiratory stridor because of during inspiration the child is showing inspiratory stridor, and also there will be retraction, that is use of intercostal muscles to make the air enter into the lungs.
So it's struggling is happening. As a result of that, there will be inspiratory stridor and retraction. So again, the air is not entering, leads to hypoxia. Then again, work and effort is increased. When the hypoxia is happening again and again, this struggling on inspiration to get the air enter into the lungs is continuing. Work and effort is increased, and as a result, there will be a negative pressure generated in the thoracic cavity. So due to this continuous struggle of air and air hunger, there will be a negative pressure inside the thoracic cavity, and as a result, there will be leakage of pulmonary vascular fluid into the interstitial spaces. So from the pulmonary area, vascular fluid will be leaving to the interstitial spaces. And again, there will be increased carbon dioxide because this inspiration is not proper, expiration also not proper. So there will be respiratory acidosis because of the accumulation of increased carbon dioxide, and the child will be going for respiratory failure. So this is the pathophysiology of acute laryngotracheobronchitis. Hope you understood. So the main mechanism is because of the inflammation, there will be narrowing of the airway, and the remaining whole portion is the struggle of the child to get in the air into the lungs. And as a result of that, the again more complications are occurring. Carbon dioxide is accumulated in the airway, and there will be respiratory acidosis and respiratory failure, and the child will be getting decreased oxygen. Okay, so that is the main problem because of this. So hope you understood the little pathophysiology. We'll see in the next video. Thank you.